Welcome to my channel Chubby Views. Today in this video you'll know about the haunted car that killed famous actor James Dean. In 1950s, James Dean was a famous young American actor. In those days, when he was at the age of 24 itself, he was a great film star. Even though he acted only 3 films, but he was a big star and a wealthy actor. He was not only an actor but also a racer. Whenever he had free time, he was participating in several racing competitions, and he also got more medals and prizes too. And he even had lots of car collections. James Dean acted in several movies such as Rebel Without a Cause and East of Eden. After filming East of Eden, he brought few cars including Triumph Tiger T110 and Porsche 356. But Dean's life ended tragically on 30th September 1955 when he crashed his newly purchased Porsche 550 car, which we wanted to use in his upcoming races. Now let's start with the story. What really happened to James Dean? Did car kill him? To know that, we will have to go 1 week before Dean's crash on 23rd September 1955. On that day, he took his brand new Porsche 550 Sider car from a famous Hollywood car customizer, George Barris. While the car was in the Barris garage, it was getting a makeover for a car as Dean requested. Barris makeovered the car as the Dean wished the car to look like. The 550 Porsche car got a new tartan seats. Number 130 was written on the sides of the car. Red stripes painted on the top of rear fenders and its new nickname, Little Bastard, written on the engine cover. After getting his car done, Dean took it for a drive around Los Angeles, where he saw a British actor, Alec Guinness. He showed him his new Porsche, but Guinness was a bit worried about the whole thing and he told him, "Please never get in it. If you get in that car, you will be found dead in it by this time next week." But Dean just laughed, saying that he was bound to die in the fast car. Sadly, as Guinness said, Dean died in it a week later. James Dean, in his diaries, he wrote that 550 Porsche car looked sinister, exhausted, hungry, and feeling a little ill-tempered. On 30th September 1955, Dean and Rolf Wutherich was a trained Porsche mechanic, were preparing for the race at Salinas. Dean suggested to drive a car so they can test drive it and they can get familiarized with the car. He was driving very speedily and got a speeding ticket by the cop for driving 65 miles per hour in a 55 miles per hour zone, and he did not get worried of it, but he was very fond to drive fast. After a short stop for drinks, Dean and Wutherich continued their trip at 5:15 p.m. Half an hour later, a black and white 1950 Ford Tudor Coupe, driving by Donald turn-up speed, was going in opposite direction to Dean. As turn-up speed made a left turn on Route 41, he suddenly crosses the center line and was heading directly into Dean's car. Dean, estimated to be going at 85 miles per hour, tried to evade the impact, but it was in vain. The two cars crashed head-on. Wutherich, mechanic, who was thrown out of the car due to the impact, and somehow managed to stay alive. Dean passed away in the hospital 30 minutes after the car crash, while Donald turn-up speed walked away with a minor scratch on his nose. The Porsche 550 of Dean's car spun out and hit into a tree, but that was not the end, as it has something sinister and haunting surrounding it, and it has that put-on curse on everyone who come close at it. Everyone thought that the haunted car 130 has killed James Dean. After the car accident, George Barris brought the haunted car for around $2,500 and decided to bring the car to his workshop. While unloading it, the car slid off the trailer and broke a mechanic's leg. Later, Barris sold the drivetrain and engine of the car to the race car drivers, that is Troy McHenry and William Estrade. They used these parts to make their own car and were racing against each other in the cars. with these 550 Porsche haunted car parts. After a few laps, McHenry lost control of his car and crashed into a tree. The impact killed him instantly, and Astrid, who was driving car on the track, wheels got locked up and car rolled over few times and got seriously injured. This is another incident that the haunted car parts took a life of a racer, Troy McHenry. After everything happened, the California Highway Patrol policers convinced him to borrow 550 haunted Porsche car to them to promote that the highway safety. At the first exhibit, the garage in which the 550 haunted car was displayed caught fire. The entire garage burned down, but car remained untouched, which was unbelievable. After this exhibition, the car was put on flatbed truck to transport it to Salinas. The driver lost control and flipped the truck, and he was thrown out of a truck and killed instantly when 550 spider haunted Porsche car landed on his. All these events continued until 1960, when ghost car was in Miami at another exhibit. This was its final exhibit, after which the car put on trailer to deliver back the haunted car to Barry's garage in Los Angeles. Both 550 haunted Porsche car and truck was vanished and haven't been seen since then. This haunted car remains mystery till now and took the lives of so many people, and we lost a great actor, James Dean. This was the word spoken by James Dean 1 month before his death.
Do you have any special advice for the young people who drive?
Take it easy driving. The life you might save might be mine.
We lost a great actor. Now we will see the memories of Alec Guinness, who warned not to drive the haunted car.
Some strange thing came over me, some almost different voice. And I said, please do not get into that car at all. It's now Thursday, whatever the day it was, 10 o'clock at night. And by 10 o'clock at night, next Thursday, you'll be dead if you get into that car.
Until now, the haunted car never found it. Thanks for watching my video. If you like my video, subscribe to my channel, click the like button and click the bell icon to know my new updates.